Hi guys, welcome to TCV Law Series. So today in our class, we'll be dealing with Section 9 and Section 10 of the Indian Patent Act, which talks exclusively about specifications. So already in my previous class, I have mentioned that when an application for patent has to be filed, it has to have either provisional specification or complete specification. So come, let's go see what these two sections talks about. Now, when an application has been filed using provisional specification, then the complete specification has to be filed within 12 months of the date of filing of the application. Otherwise, the application shall be deemed to be abandoned. In case two or more applications have been filed with provisional specification, where one application is the modification of the other, then altogether, a single complete specification can be filed if the controller is of the opinion that one application is the modification of the another and that altogether it would constitute a single invention and it can fall under a single patent. For example, if you are inventing a cream to cure pimples and you are filing a patent application for it with provisional specification, let's say on 1/1/2020. Now, after 10 days, you are inventing a cream to cure acne and you are filing patent application for it along with provisional specification. Now, for both you have filed provisional specification and not complete. So, the previous part what I told you was that within 12 months when you are filing a provisional specification, you have to file complete specification within 12 months time period, right? Now, in this scenario, what happens is that since you filed both provisional specification and both are dealing with a cream which deals with skin disorders, now the controller may say you can file all together, that is for both the first invention's patent application, that which you filed on 1/1/2020, and for the next one which you filed 10 days later, all together you can file a single complete specification and say it is a single invention. That is, instead of saying a cream to cure pimple and cream to cure acne separately, why don't you put both of things together and say it is a cream to cure facial skin disorders like that and file a single complete specification. And this will be allowed only if the controller, the patent controller, thinks that both of this can fall under a single aspect. Right now for this example, both pimple and acne deals with facial skin disorders, so he can say don't put it as separate application, put all together in a single patent application and let it be altogether a single invention, not two separate inventions. So the controller says put it together, then or you can put it as a single invention and single complete specification will be allowed. Now, if you're filing an application and you're filing it with complete specification, so you're thinking your invention is fully ready, so you're directly filing it with complete specification. Now, after you're filing the patent application, only you're realizing that some extra things you need to add or you can modify your invention more, then what will you do? Because once you file complete specification, what can you do? So then you have a separate provision which says that you can ask for the patent controller to say, please change my complete specification to provisional specification. I need to do some more changes to it. Now, you can ask this thing within 12 months time period only, because after 12 months you can't do anything else. So once you're filing the application with complete specification, then within 12 months duration itself, you should ask for the patent controller's permission to change it from complete specification to provisional specification. Now, what is the basic purpose of filing patent application using provisional specification? The basic purpose is to get priority date. Now, in case you don't want that priority date, in that scenario, what happens is that when you're filing an application, either with provisional specification or you have changed your complete specification to provisional specification, in that scenario and you're never interested in this priority date, then you can postdate your priority date to the date of filing of the complete specification and not for the provisional specification. Now let's see what Section 10 says. Now Section 10 deals with contents of specification. Now every specification, be it provisional specification or complete specification, every specification
it should have these four things. That is, it should describe the invention and it should begin with the title. So in this title, you will mention the subject matter of your invention. Then you need to have drawings. So drawing is not mandatory, but if the controller is asking you to provide a drawing of it, then you have to provide drawing. The next thing is you have to provide a model or sample, and this is also only for the controller's aspect. So if a controller is asking you, only then you have to show a model or a sample. But this model and sample won't fall into the part of specification. So it is only in certain cases. That's why I am mentioning all these four things are coming up. So what all? Describe the invention, title, drawing, then model or sample. Every complete specification. So previously I spoke about every specification. Now it's regarding only complete specification. Now every complete specification, it will have four things. What is it? That you will describe the invention. Now here you will describe it fully, in more detail, fully how it has to be used, everything, full and full you will describe. Next, you will describe about the best method of performing that invention. So you should say whether using this invention left to right is the correct aspect or right to left is the correct aspect. Like what is the best way to use that? That you will mention it. The next thing you will say is that everything, whatever you are mentioning in that specification, it should end with the claim. Now the claim is where you are seeking protection itself. When you are inventing, you should say my invention is working. Let's say generally one I have invention, it's working from right to left. Your invention is very new, it is working from left to right. Then you should claim for it. You should say that's why I need protection. My invention is different, it is unique. That's where your claim rise, right? So every line you should end it with a claim or claims, and this claim will relate to a single invention or to a group of inventions.
For example, let's say that you have invented a self-assisting wheelchair. Then your claim shall be for the entire self-assisting wheelchair on the whole. That is, it is relating to a single invention. Now let's say that this particular self-assisting wheelchair has a particular button pressing which the wheelchair will unfold by itself. Now this button on the whole itself is a separate invention. Now let's say that you can control this wheelchair using Bluetooth. Now controlling of devices using Bluetooth itself is a separate invention. Now these two inventions, that is Bluetooth control and that button used for self-unfolding, both are separate inventions, but then they relate to a single inventive concept, that is self-assisting wheelchair. That's where we say that a claim can relate to a single invention, that is either to the wheelchair on the whole or to a group of inventions linked to form a single inventive concept, that is the wheelchair, the self-unfolding button and the Bluetooth control. All these things, that is separate inventions, are linked to form a single inventive concept, that is the self-assisting wheelchair.
And next thing is it should have an abstract. Now this abstract deals with technical information. Now this abstract can be amended by the controller because it deals full and full with technical aspects. So if common person won't be able to understand, then the controller may change it in a simple language. So it is up to the controller's hand to decide it. When it comes to complete specification in case of biological material, now what happens is that in biological material you won't be able to say describe the invention, you won't be able to say the best method of performing that invention, right? So the application shall be deemed to be completed only by filing that application to the International Depository Authority under the Budapest Treaty. Now this authority will be dealing it in detail when I am taking about all the conventions. In case you are filing international application designating India, you have to keep in mind that when it comes to international applications, only complete specification can be filed and not provisional specification. Now this complete specification will contain title, the description, drawings, abstract and claims. Okay guys, so today in our class we saw section 9 and section 10, which talks about provisional specification and complete specification and its contents. So in our next class, we'll be dealing with section 11, which talks about priority dates. Thank you for watching this video. If you guys like my class, then please do like and subscribe to my channel. Thank you.